Welcome to this brief guide on how to use data models and Power Pivot in Excel. Pivot tables are a great way for you to be able to filter your data and find the information you need. However, if your information is split across multiple disparate tables, this can be quite difficult. So today I'm going to show you how you can use a data model and Power Pivot to make this easier than ever. Here you can see I have my grade information with student IDs, class IDs, and grades. But if I wanted to utilize this information and find out potentially, say, what sort of score Clara got in the Intro to Communication class and what semester she took that class in, I would need to cross-reference back and forth between multiple tables in order to be able to find this out. This is not something that I can easily do with just a regular pivot table. So instead, we're going to use a very special feature of Excel, which is known as Power Pivot. A Power Pivot is a very special version of a pivot table because it allows us to use our own data set, which is known as a data model. Now, in order to create that data model, we'll need to activate the Power Pivot option. And if you've never used it before, simply type in Power Pivot into the search field at the top of your Excel window, and the top search result there will be an option to enable Power Pivot. Once you've got that enabled, you'll end up with a new tab at the end of your ribbon. So as you can see here, I have the tab that is called Power Pivot. We select that and it'll give us a few new options here. The one that we're going to utilize today is the Add to Data Model option. Now, what sort of data are we going to add to our data model? Well, that's going to be all of our tables. So we simply select any cell inside our first table and select the option that says Add to Data Model. When you click on this, it's going to open up the data model window, and what you'll see is our table has been inserted there, and it's named it as Table Grades because it's come from our grades worksheet. Now we simply select the student details one, click on Add to Data Model, and that window will pop up again, but now you'll see we'll have both of our students and our grades tables. So obviously now we just need to add in the last couple there as well, so I'm going to do the same thing with our classes, Add to Data Model, and then the last one there, our semesters. Click into the table and click on Add to Data Model. And now we have all of our tables into our data model set. We need to tell Excel what are the connections between these tables, so it knows how they relate to each other. So for instance, my semester ID column lines up with the semester column here. And for instance, the class ID column over here will line up yet again with the class ID column over here. So now that we have these relations, how do we link them to each other? Well, that's easy enough to do. We need to head to the Design tab inside our Data Model window and select the option that says Create Relationship. This will give us another pop-up, and what you'll see is that the class column is automatically highlighted because that was the last one I had just selected. So in the drop-down at the bottom here, I need to select the other table that it connects to, which in this case is the Grades table, and you can see I have the class ID column highlighted. Now, if I was to select OK, that would form the relationship between these two columns. But instead, I'm going to show you a much more visual and easier way to form these relationships. Using the Home tab in your data model window, we want to select the option for Diagram View. This will give you a much more visual representation of each of the tables in your dataset, as well as each of the columns in those tables. And so now, I need to form the relationships, say for instance from the student ID column in both the grades and students tables. And that's as easy as simply clicking and dragging to essentially connect the dots between them. And now you can see I have that one relationship between those two tables. And class ID lines up with the class ID column over here, and that forms that relationship, and then semester lines up with semester ID at the end here in the semesters table. And believe it or not, that's all I need to do. With three simple relationships, the information in my students table is able to be cross-referenced against the information in my classes table, as well as the information in my semesters table. They're all linked through their relationships with the information found in the grades table. And now that I've got my data model configured, I can simply close down this window and I'm ready to create my pivot table. Now, just like I would normally do, I select a blank cell and I'm going to head to the Insert tab in my ribbon. But instead of selecting the usual pivot table button, I'm going to utilize the drop-down menu beneath it, so that way I can select the option that says From Data Model. This is going to insert a pivot table for us, but just like we'd expect it to, it's going to utilize the information that's found in the data model that we've just finished creating. So now I'll just zoom this in so it's a little bit easier to see. And in the sidebar over on the right-hand side, you'll notice that we have our pivot table fields. This is where we can find all of the different data model sources that we created. And I can do what I would normally do with any pivot table and simply drag and drop the options that I'd like. So I'm going to have the student names in the rows, and then I'm going to maybe go to the classes here and I'm going to grab that lovely little class name and I'm going to put that into the filter so that I can filter down to an individual class to find these particular grades. I'll drop the grades into the values because that's the information I want to sort, and then I also wanted to know what semester someone took a particular course in, so I'm going to drop that into my columns. And now I have a much easier set of data to work with. In fact, I can even utilize the filter that I created and limit it only to an individual class. So for example here, I'm going to limit my results to Introduction to Communication 1, and I've easily filtered out my data, and I can see at a glance that Clara has taken the course of Introduction to Communication 1, and she took this course in fall of 2019 and was given a score of 53. And I haven't had to do any time-consuming manual cross-referencing between tables in order to be able to find this information out. And that is how you create your very own data model for use with Power Pivot. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it saves you plenty of time in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.